Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Dirk Albrecht. I would like to ask for your kind attention for the next 10 minutes. I would like to introduce you to one of the highlights of this Arkema, the new Cubis individual. This is a product where we implement SOP standard workflows, weighing related workflows directly into our Cubis balances. Before I start with the demonstration how this really works, I would like to give you a little bit the background. If we look into a laboratory, a normal pharmaceutical laboratory, we always find a similar setup. You have a leading system, a LIMS or LIS system, a laboratory information management system, which is very often implemented. And on the lower level, you find the devices and the analyzers. But very often, there is a media break between the LIMS system and the device level, because those devices are not connected. By this, you will see that the LIMS system prints out the task for the lab. The people in the lab go around writing down the measurements they perform on the devices, for example, on the balances. And then they type it in back into the analyzers in order to get the analyzed results directly transferred into the LIMS system back. By this setup, problems come up. And these problems are identified on a global base. Because by this handling, you see that the efficiency is getting lost. People in the lab waste a lot of time or spend a lot of time during the day for documentation. This could be time where they could work productively on the analyses they have to do. On the other hand, very often the LIMS systems they are using are very old, so they cannot be upgraded in order to get instruments directly connected into the LIMS system. So we see some trends coming up, global trends, asking for more efficiency in the lab, having a better sample management, creating more efficiency by implementing software layers between the devices and the LIMS system, the so-called middleware. The middleware, which, like the name says, stands between the devices and the LIMS system, this middleware has some certain tasks. On one hand, to connect the instruments directly. On the other hand, to transport and to handle the data, which is produced on the lowest level. And last but not least, to control the workflows and the SOPs. Sartorius has now invented the Cubis individual, and we have two highlights in there. On one hand, we have the connectivity, meaning getting the balances connected to the LIMS system by offering a brand new standard of communication called web services. These web services are a web-based communication standard which is established and validated on a global base. By this, it is possible to control balances on a very simple way, which can be done by nearly everyone who can program on XML base, and which offers a new functionality by not only getting data, even by controlling the balance from externally. On the other hand, we have, beside the connectivity, we have implemented workflows in the Cubis. And we have two kinds of workflows available, one standardized and one individually created. The standardized ones, we call them Q apps, are available on the internet. They can be downloaded from the new Sartorius App Center, where customers can see what is possible, which workflows we offer. They can download free of charge, implement them via SD card transfer into their Cubis balance and use them for 30 days. If they're interested in, they can purchase this app afterwards. I prepared a little demonstration now with a very interesting app called UserCal. It's a user-defined calibration which I would like to show you now. These apps are located in the task list of the Cubis balances. And depending on who is logged on, a certain setup is coming. When you are logged on as an administrator, you will find two levels. One level is the definition of the calibration process. The other level, which is for the users, is the real process to be performed. In the administration mode, you can define the process. by selecting on how many points the calibration should be done. Sartorius recommends to calibrate the balance on 3 points, and then you can decide if the balance shall perform an internal adjustment using the internal adjustment device before the calibration or no. Afterwards, you define the weights for the for these calibration points by giving it an ID, writing the nominal mass, and defining the tolerance for this calibration point in percent or absolute in grams. This now can be done for all the 3 points that are defined. So, if you now log on as a normal user and you start this process, you will directly go into the calibration process, and now the balance informs the user about what he has to do. You are asked to remove all samples from pen and to tear the instrument. Now, it asks you for the first calibration weight. In our example, 100 milligrams. At stability, the balance now decides if this calibration point is valid or no, and it evaluates it by itself. So the result here is not influenced by the user. And you directly get the feedback if this calibration point was performed well or not. Now you're asked to place the second calibration weight. But before you have to tear, for sure. And again, like on the first calibration point, at stability, the balance takes the weight, evaluates it according to the tolerances which were defined before, and the user gets the feedback if the calibration point was passed or failed. So now we come to the last calibration point after tearing the instrument. The last calibrated weight is taken over, and at the end of the process, you will get a very nice evaluation, which is displayed, which can now be printed on a connected printer, or which can be directly sent onto an FTP server if your instrument is connected with your network. You see, these integrated workflows, like the user call that I showed you, ensure that the SOPs, which are so important for your processes, are ensured 100%. The user just has to follow what the balance shows him to do. Thank you very much.